happy home. And then you work on yourself, lose over 100 pounds, and become unrecognizable, both inside and out. You hang out more and ultimately step out on your marriage. There's hurt, pain, and a divorce. Mm. You live life with regret, but your story isn't finished.
What I thought at the time was love. I had never felt that before, ever. I have never felt so more desired in my life, ever.
Was sleeping with your husband difficult?
Very.
Why?
Because I only wanted the other guy.
Wow. I'm obviously not yours and you're not mine. Mm-hmm. But
no,
I don't
he
want
was
you...
mine. He was mine. I'm sorry, honey. He was mine.
What's up, YouTube? What's up? It's your boy, Mr. Nobody, and I'm back in the vibe. What's going on with y'all, man? What's going on? Okay, so today, we're going to do a quick, well, it's not quick, it's a long reaction to this certain story that it's going to blow your mind. Let's just put it like that. And this young lady here, she did something great. She lost over 100 pounds. But the sad thing is what she did when she lost the 100 pounds. She decides to leave her family. Husband and a 1-month-old daughter. Is it 1 month? 1 year. Anyway, she left her daughter. So I want you guys to straddle in on this one. Like I said, it's a good little story. So hang in there to the end, but it has a lot of twists to it, and you guys got to see this. Got to see this. Before we do, take the time out, subscribe to the channel, like, share, and hit that notification bell. Now let's get it.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good.
Good.
I usually jump right into the interviews. I don't like to take the scenic route, as I like to say.
Good.
How did you ruin your marriage?
Infidelity. I will say that is the simplest way to put it.
Infidelity. Mm-hmm. I feel like the narrative is always the man cheats.
Yes.
The man messed up. We were having a conversation off camera, and you was just like, everybody that you talk to says, well, what did he do?
Yeah.
What do you feel about that narrative?
Yeah. I think people automatically go to the man being the problem. So when I say, you know, I'm divorced, whatever, they're like, oh, God, what did he do? Oh, good for you. You can do better. You know, and it's sort of like, oh, it was me. It wasn't him.
How was your marriage? Was this like a tumultuous relationship that you had? If you could give me just a little backstory about like how the dynamic of the relationship was.
So we met when I was about 19, and he became my best friend. Mm. We decided to get married a few years later. We got married very young. I was about 23 at the time. Got married very young, and he was amazing. He was a great provider. He was a good friend, and things were good. We had a baby. Things were good until they weren't.
And why weren't they?
Well, before when we met, I was 130 pounds heavier. So I lost 130 pounds and kind of lost my mind, so to speak.
But you lost 130 pounds in the relationship?
In the relationship. When we got married, I was 320 pounds at my heaviest. I lost the weight and kind of went south.
Just paying attention to this young lady's demeanor and everything. And, you know, they always say they want the good guys and all this. This man married her at her heaviest, 320 pounds. And as soon as you lost the weight, you decide, I'm going to go find me somebody else better. Or better yet, you want to start acting different. He took you at your worst, and as soon as you got your best, he's not good enough now. But there's more, guys. Y'all pay attention. I was just checking her out, man, just looking at her demeanor and stuff, how she's talking about this. She's like it ain't nothing. Like it ain't nothing.
Was this the first time that you ever been slimmer and like?
Yes. All my life I've been fat girl. So this was the first time that I actually got to be the it girl, so to speak, you know.
And what about your husband?
What about him? You mean like?
Weight-wise, was he? Oh,
well, he was a bigger guy, but it wasn't too crazy at the time. He was a bigger guy, but he loved me big. He never complained. He always complimented me, treated me like I was beautiful, but I didn't feel beautiful. So I went ahead with the weight loss.
There's a narrative about big women. Right?
So men love big women.
One of the narratives that I hear is that big women know how to treat a man, right? It's sort of because, I don't know, like, maybe the world isn't at their feet. Yeah. Maybe they do have to be humble and the humility to have people like them or be into them or, you know, sort of. So from the big girl perspective, can you speak to that?
Well, not really, because he was obsessed with me. I mean, when I say in a healthy way, he loved me deeply. And I never felt like I had to do a lot to keep him around. He always wanted to be around.
Right. So maybe not with him, but I mean like in other relationships that you've had in the past or men that you've been around in the past or been with, whatever.
Okay. So like I hadn't had many relationships, but a few that I did have, I don't know. I felt like the fat girl.
Right.
Yeah. And so.
Do you feel like you have to be extra nice?
Feel like I had to be extra nice, but I felt like I had to go above and beyond with like fashion or my hair. I always had to be, everything had to be in place. If I was going to be fat, I was going to be fat and fly.
So he worshiped the ground you walked on. What made you lose the weight?
I was just tired of feeling that way. I was tired of feeling how I felt. So I was
speaking to someone that used to be fat and they're a fitness person now. And which one of the things she said to me was, there's not a fat person that isn't depressed.
I can agree with that. I was very depressed when I was at that weight. Very. Even throughout my marriage. And even my ex-husband would reassure me and tell me, you're beautiful, don't worry. I still felt bad within myself.
So he watches you lose this weight. But he loved you for who you were.
Yeah.
But you didn't love you for who you were.
Exactly.
Does he not diet with you? Does he not go to the gym with you? Does he not want to do all those things? Or he just sort of like...
He just supported me.
Right.
He was kind of comfortable where he was, and his main focus was just me and supporting me.
So his main focus was assisting you.
Yes.
And just supporting you and being there for you.
Yes. Absolutely.
Where did it go wrong? When you lost that weight, you looked in the mirror and then you were just like, hold on. Do you think that he could have married that girl that lost 130 pounds?
Honestly, probably not.
See, there's a lot going on right here. A lot going on right here. She's claiming, you know, she sound like, oh, I'm being fat and, oh, I'm so depressed and... Woe is me and all this. But you're married and a child. A lot of women are single, thin, and don't have kids, wishing they had a good man. But you have it. But you're not happy because you're fat. But you've been fat all your life. And now you decide you want to get depressed after you got a man and a child. Somebody explain that shit to me. Now you want to be depressed once you got a good man and a child and married. Now you depressed. You weren't depressed prior to that. Then you're going to say some more corny shit like, well, if I was at this weight, this 130 pounds lighter, I wouldn't pick this dude. That's what she's saying. There's no way in the hell I would have got with him. A lot of disrespectful shit in here. I'm glad they did split up. She's full of crap, man. Get the hell.
Or that he would even want to.
Oh, I look pretty amazing, so he probably would have wanted to. But I don't think he could have. Now thinking back, I don't think so. Mm-mm. Yeah.
Do you think that he felt that when he looked at you?
I think that he felt betrayal. How could you do this? And I met you at this weight. How could you lose this weight and just totally change when I met you at this weight?
You think that he felt betrayal?
I think that he did, because he supported me. He was there for me when I was 320 pounds. Mm. But then when I lost the weight, I was different. My right. behaviors were different.
Mm. What do you mean?
I dressed differently. I wore more fitting clothes. I started to go out a lot more with my girlfriends, more than ever.
Right,
I started getting a lot of attention, a lot more attention from men. And I didn't know how to handle it.
Now, who does this sound like? Recently, who does this sound like? Keke Palmer, doesn't it? Keke Palmer changed when she had her kid. Her skin cleared up. I guess she got the mummy makeover, got a little body on her, got some ass on her. And she went crazy. Dressing crazy, hanging out with her friends, disrespecting the dude, grinding on other people. The little change, and but forget about that little change now make you forget about the ones that was with you when you were at your worst. Y'all killing me, man. Fuck out of here.
I just couldn't handle it.
I think about two different mentalities, right?
Mm-hmm.
I think about the girl that gets the BBL.
Mm-hmm.
One day, I don't know, let's say she has an undesirable body.
Mm-hmm.
The next day, she's the most desirable woman in the world.
Mm-hmm.
There's a mentality that goes into that, right?
Yes.
Because in your mind, you're still that girl before the body. You can't just change that overnight.
Right.
But when you lose the weight and you put in the work for the weight to be gone, I feel like the mentality is sort of gradual and you sort of become that person in a different way.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think about that?
Well, let me correct you. So I had weight loss surgery. So I didn't put in as much work. It's kind of similar to getting a BBL. You go in one day and you don't have a desirable body, and then you come out and you do. With weight loss surgery, it's gradual, but it's kind of quick when you lose the weight. You lose the weight pretty quickly. I lost 100 pounds in 6 months. So it was quick.
What kind of surgery was this?
Sleeve, gastric sleeve.
Okay, and
yeah.
They just...
So they make your stomach smaller so you can consume less.
I've heard about this.
Yeah.
I've heard about
Very
this.
Old surgery. Yeah, everybody's getting it now. Everybody and their mama. Everybody.
Okay.
It's crazy because she say everybody's getting this stuff. You're right. Everybody is going under the knife. And no one is learning how to learn how to eat properly, exercise, and get it like you're supposed to. You go jump out there, get it cheap, and then you get these fucking balloon bodies. And the only ones that y'all attract are them elf boys. And that's what happened to her. Just pay attention. It's coming. Why?
So you're going out, you hanging out more.
Yeah.
Does he say something to you?
At first, he kind of let it slide. Mm-hmm. He stayed at home with the baby. I had a 1-year-old at the time.
Wow.
And he stayed at home with the baby, and he kind of let me do my thing. Yeah, at first.
And then it was like, all right.
And then he was like, okay, do you have to go out every weekend?
Oh, he was out every weekend.
And during the week sometimes.
So you're meeting men?
Well, no, not at first. So I was getting a lot of attention from men.
Right.
But at first, that was all it was. It was nothing any more than that. Just the attention. Mm. Yeah.
Bring me to the day you cheated for the first time.
So, met a guy at work, and we started to become friends. He was very flirtatious, gave me a lot of attention. I had just had a baby. I was about a year postpartum, and I was feeling, I mean, the weight was gone, but I was still feeling bad. I was feeling bored and frumpy, and I just wanted some excitement. And he and I became friends, and it was innocent at first. And then it gradually started to progress into something a little more inappropriate each day. You know, I worked with this guy.
Work husband.
I had to see him.
Yeah.
You know, he took me to my car if it was too dark at night, whatever. And we began to talk on the phone. It was over after that.
The phone.
We started talking. We became friends. And it was like, well, let's go out for a drink.
Mm.
I'm like, okay, cool. So then now I'm lying to my husband saying I'm going out with the girls when really I'm going to meet him. And
mercy.
It just gradually worked itself up from there. And I was just so enamored with this person and his personality and his charisma. Mm. And he wasn't boring. And I was excited to go to work. Mm. You know, it was crazy. It was crazy.
So now y'all know why us men don't believe in that work husband shit or that male best friend shit. Because he so easily, all of a sudden. Now, y'all work together. He ain't never slid up on you. After these 6 months, all of a sudden, he's all up in your face just smiling and talking. And now y'all hanging out and getting fucking Jabba Juice together and hanging out. And, oh, my God, I can't get this man off my mind type shit. And now you're doing inappropriate shit. But the only thing about all this is he couldn't do not one thing unless you allowed him. That's the key to all this. He didn't do it. You did it. You let him in there. That's where you fucked up.
Wow. Oh, man. Like, you experiencing that, it was such a new feeling.
Yes, very new. I had never felt that way before in my life, ever. Like the excitement, what I thought at the time was love, I had never felt that before, ever. I have never felt so more desired in my life, ever. And even though my husband, he was very uplifting, you're beautiful, you're this, but this was different. This was, not only did he tell me I was beautiful, but I actually felt it. Too. You know, when my husband would tell me, I'd be like, oh, whatever, you're supposed to say that. Mm-hmm. But when this guy, it was just different.
It was just different. Even the way he speak about it, you know.
Yeah.
I could tell that it sort of brings you back to that
very
feeling.
Very intense.
So you're out for a drink. You have a drink. Mm-hmm. It goes too far.
Way too far. We started talking every single day, meeting before work, staying late after work. And it just progressed from there.
Where did y'all have sex at?
Oh, wow. At a hotel for the first time.
Okay.
Yeah. At a hotel.
You set it up like, all right, this is going to happen.
Well, he set it up. We talked about it a lot. I was very scared because I had never stepped out in my relationship ever. Mm. So I was very, very scared. But I was willing to take the risk because that's how intense the relationship between us had got.
It's interesting that you said, I never stepped out in my relationship, but you were emotionally stepping out of your relationship and how we don't sort of factor that into like the cheating aspect. And which is probably the more dangerous thing that we could be doing, right?
Yeah. It's like, but I meant before him.
I had never
emotionally, I wasn't talking to anybody, never. Mm-hmm. When I met him, that's when it all started. The emotional cheating and then the physical cheating.
Right.
Yeah.
See, I don't think she really understood what he was saying. What he was saying is, prior to going to the hotel, you know, when he's coming up to you and doing all this other stuff, emotionally, you was giving him too much of your time, too much of your personal time, and the affection was starting to kick in because you was allowing him to talk to you certain kind of ways, knowing that you're married. But you're allowing him to sit there and you know, spend these sweet nothings in your ear, and you sitting there listening, giggling like a little fucking child and acting like you ain't got no fucking common sense. You know what I'm saying? See, that's what's going on. That's what he said. Nah, you was emotionally cheating prior to actually physically cheating. That's what he was trying to say. So she didn't say how long the time period was. It's like when she lost that weight, because he didn't come up till she lost the weight. Let's just be real. 320 pounds, brother wasn't doing that. He wasn't doing that. And he probably the fucking office hoe. Let's just be real. He probably don't slept with everybody up there. And she was just fucking shits and giggles. That's all.
After that hotel, we call it Pandora's box, right?
Oh, yeah.
Because
yeah.
once you open it, it's impossible to close.
Impossible.
It's impossible. Once you open that up,
yep.
What was the difference in being at home? What was the energy like when you went back home? What you now, like we said, we've uncovered it.
Yeah.
The forbidden. Some things are left off limits because God knows we cannot cut it off.
Can't handle it.
Right. So what was that dynamic like when you come back home and nobody knows and it's still your secret?
Well, it was exciting because it was a secret. Mm-hmm. But when I came home, I loathed coming home. I did not want to come home. Mm. I wanted to be in that excitement, that euphoria forever. Mm. I hated coming home. Mm. So it was hard. I lived a double life. I was a different person at work and with him. And I was a different person at home with my baby and with my ex-husband. It was hard. It was very exhausting, but it was so exciting and enchanting. And I did not want to stop. It became an addiction.
Was sleeping with your husband difficult?
Very.
Why?
Because I only wanted the other guy.
Wow.
I was so in love. I thought I was in love. I was, you know, my random, crazy, mixed up depiction of love. That's what I felt at the time. And I didn't want anybody but him. Nobody.
And at this time, is this other guy married?
He was. I didn't know at the time. I just thought he had a live-in girlfriend, but it turns out that was his wife.
You got to be kidding me. You doing... I'm not even going to do it. Not gonna do.
Wow.
Yeah.
Did you find it easier to cheat with somebody that was with somebody?
Yo.
Did you not care? You was just so enamored by this one individual.
Well, I didn't care. Okay. I was so enamored. Mm-hmm. It wasn't his wife, so I thought I was okay. I'm like, whatever. It's just your baby mama. Who cares? Mm-hmm. But I was a little jealous because there were times I wanted to be with him and I couldn't because he had someone else. I had way more freedom than him.
And that's the thing.
Way more.
You do this thing, mm-hmm. right? And I'm obviously not yours, and you're not mine.
Mm-hmm.
But
no,
I don't.
He
want
was
you...
mine. He was mine. I'm sorry, honey. He was mine at the time.
She's still not over that man.
So
bro.
I
see. This says it all right here. She's still into this dude. He probably broke it off with her. Cause she the one want to like. Leave her whole life and be with him. And then this fool got a whole family at home. And then she said to me, no, he's mine. He's mine. She's still delusional about the whole situation. That's what y'all asses get. You left your man for an elf boy, an office elf boy. And now you're by yourself. That's
thought, right? I was going crazy. Nearly lost it. He was mine at the time.
So when you found out this is actually his wife, how do you feel? Does your feelings change? Does your disposition change? Like, or do you just like, you know what? I don't give a
Well, actually, I didn't find out until it was over between him and I.
Oh.
But it crushed me, even after the fact. It crushed
Why?
Me. Because I felt like he lied. Like, how could you lie to me? We here. Mm. You know, we tell each other everything. How could you lie? Mm. So I felt betrayed. It was over by that point, so it was nothing.
The height of your infidelity.
Mm-hmm.
The height. What was that? What was a regular day like?
Oh, it was euphoria. It was talking to him and texting him all day. It was getting in trouble at work because I'm in my phone all day. It was lying, figuring out how I'm going to lie to get out of the house this evening because I got to get to this man. We're going out. I don't care what it is. I got to go. Mm. So at the height of my infidelity, it was just euphoric. Mm. It was euphoric. That's the only way I can describe it.
Damn.
It's a cold world.
I see you go back to that place. It's,
yeah.
It's very interesting to watch. How does your husband find out?
I confessed.
Yeah. Wow. You confessed.
I confessed. I couldn't sleep. My conscience was eating me alive, and I was exhausted from all the lies. And, you know, I had to be one person at work, one person with him, one person at church.
That's too much.
It was too much. I couldn't talk to anybody about it.
And this is how, after
how long?
Who are
you?
Maybe like 18 months or so.
Wow, that's a long time.
Yeah.
To be that connected to someone else.
Yeah, yeah.
And be doing this secret with someone else.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Y'all was fucking on the job.
Yeah.
Y'all was fucking on the job.
I mean, yeah, we have. It has happened. It did happen a couple times.
No,
but most of the time, it was set up for hotel stays.
Yeah, no, I'm being messy. Sorry.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a long time to be, let alone, not just talking to somebody for 18 months.
I was exhausted. Yeah. I was exhausted. It became very messy between me and the other guy because I wanted his time. Mm. And he knew what it was.
Yeah, men
know. I didn't know what it was. I mean, I knew, but I didn't want to accept it.
Yeah.
I thought that the relationship that we had was so powerful that I could change his mind.
You know what's crazy? I heard this, like, one, I don't know if it's a quote, but it was just like, you never hear the story about the side dude, right?
Yeah.
Like, the side dude never comes out like,
yeah
it was me.
Yeah, but you hear a lot of side chicks.
Because maybe women get that emotional attachment that men sort of can just disconnect from.
Yeah,
you think
unfortunately.
That?
I don't think he disconnected that easy, but way easier than myself.
Mm-hmm.
He knew what it was. He was more logical about it than I was.
Mm-hmm.
I was ready to leave my baby, leave my family. This was nice. I love y'all. I see y'all on the weekend. I wanted to be with him at all costs.
You was ready to leave your kid.
When I say leave my kid, I mean, here, Dad, you can have her. I'll see y'all on the weekend.
Now, imagine a guy saying, no, let's put it like this. Imagine a black guy said that he's going to leave his wife and his daughter to be with another woman. So plainly, like she said. Just imagine it. Just imagine when the ex-husband actually hear this story. It's like, wow, you really thought that. And then you better hope the daughter don't ever hear this shit. But you was cuckoo for Cocoa Pucks, man. Damn, he had you.
If this don't work out, she's yours. Just let me be happy with him.
Awesome.
Looking back on that now, I'm like, ugh, it's cringy. It is cringy, but I was gone. My mind was gone at the time.
Yeah,
I was really in love, so I thought.
But the euphoria that you described earlier, it can't be manufactured, you know?
I had never felt that way before, ever.
So you tell him, what does he say? How do you tell him? I know you went back and forth in your mind about
probing.
It a couple of times.
He had been probing. Okay. And I went back and forth in my mind about it. I talked to a therapist about it because it was haunting me.
Of course.
I talked to my therapist about it. I had talked to my mom about it. And I talked to my pastor about it.
Mm.
I was going crazy. I couldn't have this guy, but I couldn't stop what we were doing. And I was just completely bored with my relationship at home.
Mm.
I just wanted to be done. I wanted, in my mind, I wanted to tell him what I had done. I wanted him to leave me and so I could be with this guy. That's what the plan was at first.
Isn't that
I had to work through that.
Yeah.
Definitely not what happened.
Hell no.
Heck no. Definitely not what happened. So, yeah.
So you tell him, what was the conversation like?
So I had went out and he had got a hold of one of my books, and I alluded to something in one of my little journals about a exciting night that I had out. Didn't use any names, but he put two and two together and he's like, what's going on?
Hmm.
And
he invaded your privacy.
He invaded my privacy and he was just rambling. He knew something was going on, but he couldn't catch me. He couldn't put his finger on it. I had all types of locks on my phone. He could not figure it out.
Right.
I was sneaking out. I was doing this, doing that, saying I was with my girlfriend, saying I was going here, lying to this man, essentially. And so he started to probe mm-hmm. around the house mm-hmm. for weeks. Mm. And he was questioning me, and it was just getting on my nerves, and I was becoming more and more anxious. I said, look, this is what it is.
Mm. That must have felt good. Just to finally
get it
off of your chest.
Just to get it off my chest. Yeah, it felt good. But the pain that I saw in his eyes, that didn't feel good. Because that was my best friend. Mm. That was my best friend, and that didn't feel good. Mm-hmm. He was so discombobulated when I told him. He was very upset. He took a walk. It was about 4 o'clock in the morning because I was out. Why are you out at 4 o'clock in the morning? I'm somebody's wife and mama, got the little baby at home. I was out. When I came in, he was up waiting, and we talked about this little thing he read in the book. I let it go. I couldn't hold it anymore. I was sick. It was making me sick, literally.
Discombobulated how?
He has so many questions. Mm. He has so many questions. Is this where you were on this day? Mm-hmm. Is this what you did when you say you were this person?
You replay every conversation.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, it was bad.
And at this point, you're just being brutally honest.
I was being honest.
Well, you were still trying to...
I was tiptoeing.
Right.
Because I was like, I don't know what this man is going to do to me. Right. I mean, I know him.
Right.
But people, you never know. People snap. And so, I was holding my baby because I'm like, he ain't going to kill me with the baby in my hand. I hope. So I was holding it. And, she didn't know. She's 1 year old. She's 2 years old at the time.
Yeah.
She didn't know what was going on. And so I'm holding the baby.
She does now.
And I'm just telling him things slowly. Not everything, mm-hmm. but some things. Mm-hmm. And it was hard for him.
He comes back in the house and then what?
He's like, I'm moving. I'm leaving. I'm going to live with my brother. I need to stay there for a couple days, a couple months. I don't know. I got to get out of here.
This might sound like a weird question, mm-hmm. but was a part of you relieved when he was?
Yes. Because I'm like, I get to be with my boyfriend now.
Oh, shit.
So a part of me was relieved. I didn't know what it entailed to have my helpmate gone. So I asked him not to leave because I showed, I wanted to show him that I was,
Yeah.
But a part of me was like, well, I get to talk on my phone all night like I really want to. I don't got to hide. I ain't got to go in the bathroom texting all night. I ain't got to make up something to get out the house.
So she actually thought this man was going to just stay there. Like she said, she had to think about the helpmate. Like, basically, she didn't have nowhere to go. She needed some bills paid. She didn't have the money, basically. But you thought you were going to sit up in this house and text and call and love this man from this house while this husband and child in there. And there was going to be no repercussion behind that shit. Like, you really thought that. You thought your man was that weak that he was going to sit there and let you do that. That's what you actually thought. That's why these women be so surprised when the guy jump up and like, I'm done with this shit. That's why they act that way. They thought they could do whatever they want and the guy's not going to. Everybody has a cutoff. Everybody got a cutoff. I don't care what you say. It might take him a couple years, whatever, but when he is done, he is done. And I think she did it. I mean... She lucky that's all she got. Let's put it that way.
And now your boyfriend is like, hold on, what you doing?
Yeah. He's like, I hope this is not for me. And I'm like,
oh, shit.
No, it's not for you, but.
But it's a little convenient.
It's convenient. He's like, well, I still have my kids, and I still have my girl. He wouldn't call her his wife. I still have my girl, my kids.
Basically telling you don't get it.
Yeah. In other words. Yeah.
You knew what this was.
Yep.
You let it go too far.
Yeah. You knew what this was. You couldn't handle it.
What do you feel about that?
I mean, he was right, and I knew he was right, but I didn't want to admit that. I didn't want to give in to that.
Mm.
I just wanted what I wanted, and I didn't care. Mm. I wanted him at the time.
You actually thought this dude was going to leave his woman and his child. Like your dumb ass. Oh, man, you got to feel stupid right now. Oh, my God. Boy, you like just dumb.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. So, does he actually leave? What do you mean?
So, he left and he stayed with a family member for a couple weeks. Mm-hmm. And we talked about it daily. Every day he had new questions. Mm-hmm. Every day he was calling me and, you know, trying to get more information about what had transpired over the year and a half, almost 2 years. And it was a lot. Mm. It was a lot of things I had to break down and tell him. There was a pregnancy he didn't know about. Well, he knew about, but he didn't know that there was someone else involved. It was a lot.
Wow. You were pregnant by the other guy?
I think. And when I say I think, it's because I was having an affair. So I was with that guy and my husband at the same time. So I didn't know.
You terminated the pregnancy?
So I had to terminate the pregnancy because I just couldn't handle that.
No,
I couldn't handle it. I didn't know what. I couldn't go through 9 months of torture like that.
And then the baby come and...
And I don't know who. Yeah.
Could this story get even worse than what it is? Could it get even worse? Like, she did everything possible. Like, she can write a whole book about all the effed up things I did to ruin a marriage. You literally got pregnant and deleted the pregnancy because you didn't know. But you already confessed to the husband that you was having an affair. So it wasn't like you need to hide the child. So you jump up and just and get rid of the child. Because of your, and why you want no birth control? Ain't using protection. Stupid. See, that's some reckless shit I be talking about out here. Anyway, it takes two. No, it takes one dummy.
Yeah. Yeah. It was hard. It was very, 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 very hard.
What did he say when you told him that you were pregnant?
He's like, so you were pregnant by him? You know, he had so many questions. And I had to explain to him, like, I don't know. You know, I was seeing him and being with you at the same time. I don't know. But at the time, financially, we weren't ready for another baby. Mm-hmm. And I was able to persuade him that this wasn't the right time. Mm. So my ex-husband, he knew about the pregnancy, but he didn't know that it may have involved someone else. I just persuaded him to, like, you know, this is not the right time. You know, I'm on birth control. There could be birth defects, you know, whatever. I shouldn't do this. Let's not do this. And he was so supportive. He's like, whatever you want to do.
This guy is just...
child, I'm flying.
When you describe him, he just sounds like the ideal guy. What do you say to the women that are in search of a man like the one you had? Like, that
they don't make him like that no more. Mm. Period. And I stand on that, 10 toes down, till this day. And he's remarried happily. I love his wife. She's wonderful with my daughter. They're really great. But I stand on that, 10 toes down. They don't make him like him anymore. So if a woman is ever that lucky to find someone remotely close, fight for that. You know, stay true to that.
If you could be with him today, would you?
No.
That's a lie.
And why is that? Too much damage?
Too much damage. And the truth is, I was unfulfilled in a lot of ways in that relationship. And I wasn't able to express it in the right way. So I was finding my identity through sex. I had this new body, and I was getting an identity through sex. It made me unfulfilled in my relationship. Mm. I was already unfulfilled. So, no, I wouldn't go back.
It's crazy. So, basically, it was all about the sex for her. That's what it was all about. Yeah, she fell in love with the guy, but she's, you know, I had to clip this out because it goes probably about a good 15, 20 minutes more, and I'm just not going to do that. But she had dealt with other guys. So she kind of got out there, with, like you said, with her new body. So she got out there, and as you can see, she can put the weight back on, and she's by herself now. And she's out there in this dating world, this new dating world, with this new old body back, and nobody. But she has something to say at the end. Do ask about, you know, anything you would like to tell someone. So let's hear what she got to say, and then boot her ass up out of here.
Yeah, it's hard. It really is.
What's something you want to leave us with? About your whole ordeal, about everything, if you could just capsulize it, you know?
I would just say, if you're in a relationship, if you're in a marriage, and it's worth the fight, try to step outside of yourself, outside of the selfishness, outside of your selfish wants and needs, and fight. Mm. Don't take the cowardly way out by cheating or, you know, whatever you might do to make yourself feel better. I would say fight. For my married women that are bored, fight. Fight. If it's worth the fight, fight. You never win when you're sneaking around doing something. Never. It's never good for anybody.
No matter how much you try to say, well, I'm going to just, it's going to be one time.
One more time, yeah. I said that so many times.
How many times?
Like, I'm never doing this again. And then 2 weeks later, which room, what's the room number?
You know? I'm coming.
I'm coming. And would do anything to get there. I didn't care, honey. I didn't care. I needed my fix. It became an addiction. So, yeah, I would just say, don't even get involved. It's too hard to get out once you open the box. It's hard to close. So, yeah. And know yourself before you're getting married. Know who you are as a person. Know who you want to be in the future. Because when you go in it clueless, who knows? I mean, two people get married, they go in their separate ways. They grow differently. You got to be able to hone that back in order to make it work. You know what I'm saying? So know who you are. I was young. I hadn't had a clue who I was. So, yeah.
And we're going to be on the lookout for your book, for all the gruesome details that I'm sure everybody's going to...
She wrote a book.
Yes, yes, yes. Got to be on the lookout. I'm working on some things.
All right, guys, if you like the video, make sure you hit that like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. And as always, stay vibing. It's your boy, Mr. Nobody. Peace.